Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follow.
It is your old boy back at it again with another video. Yes, you better hit that like button or I'm going to unsubscribe from your YouTube channel. Comment and I will subscribe to your YouTube channel and you'll have plus one subscriber. Yeah, see ya. Thumbs up. So, what's up guys? Yes, I'm playing DBZ Kakarot. We're doing this. I want to get one thing out the way. Okay, welcome back. And two. I won't be doing any gameplays because my mic, something's wrong with it, and I don't know why. Hold up. So welcome back, guys. But besides the point, welcome back, and today we're going to be doing what if Gohan had 8 to 1. Now, Goten, yes, you will be coming in this arc. Don't worry, because I knew. And go watch the first part. This was inspired by Salad Saiyan. It's really cool, bro. Like, his channel is like, you think my channel's cool? Bro, you don't even know what you're doing. You don't even know what you're doing watching my channel. Go check out his channel, my dude. Bro, his channel will be in the description down below. Go dig in your nose if you think it won't. So, how about we get right into this one? And we'll be starting off at the, let's say, before his resurrection. This is a good point to get started. Because, yeah, I know, I'm talking a lot. Leave me alone. I like talking. Talking is good for your health. That's the reason why we have a mouth anyway, ain't it? Sorry, I know I'm just talking now. So, now we start our story off up with the Dragon Balls. Yes, I said with the Dragon Balls. Goku, yes, and Dende is, yeah. No. Goku would wish for two people to come back. Part of his family. And he never really got to know them. But since his brother Raditz is here, why can't he involve them? They can be pretty strong, especially if they have his blood and Raditz's blood. So why and their Saiyans, and more Saiyans the merrier. And he brings back Gine and your homeboy, the dude from my main What If series that I always talk about, Bardock. Now. Gine gets to know Chi-Chi. And when she finds out about Chi-Chi, she asks Goku if she could stay away from battle. He said, Goku being nicer in this timeline for reasons, because he has a son. He tells her, Mom, I don't care if you're on battle or not. As long as I have you, I'm all happy. And he heads out to fight in the world tournament. The world tournament would go the same. Because all the extra characters wouldn't be in it. Like, Bardock would just be there on the sidelines if anything bad happened. Yeah, the first part of the Buu Saga goes the same until the fight with Deborah. Now, Gohan would try to fight first, but then he would get launching himself into Deborah because of what his what his people did to his Videl. Sends him out. And he charges at Deborah! And dodging out of the way. Deborah spits at him. And not knowing what's going on, he doesn't move. Not knowing what this does, he's just like, your spit doesn't affect me. Trying to move it out the way or something like that. Like what those people do. He gets turned into stone and falls to the ground. Now, Bardock will walk up saying, now that's my grandson you're messing with. So why don't you back down from this fight before you get hurt? Me? Get hurt? That's a funny joke you got there. I'm the strongest person you'll ever fight. You're filthy old Super Saiyan nobody. Coming back to life late in the story tale won't do nothing. What did you say to me? You filthy old Majin Buu reject. All right, I'm gonna kill you now. When you do 1 + 2, you get 3. And when you count, and you count 1 to 2, next is 3. This is my Super Saiyan 3 form. Me and my son couldn't finish training fully, and he has one more form up his sleeve. So even if I do lose this fight, my son can beat you easily. And remember this, I'm not like my son, my grandson. Charging into battle is the wrong thing to do, especially in base form. Goku, why didn't you teach him that? Don't even give me an answer. Let me beat this dude up. The boar spits at Bardock. Don't even try it! Kneeing him in the face, sending the boar flying. What? What type of power is that? Dad, remember the power drain! You've got it. No! Rebellion? Charge! And charge! Hitting the boar right in the stomach, sending him flying. And it's like how Superman, you know how in DC when Superman puts both of his arms out and just starts flying, throwing him into mountains? Well, Bardock's only using one hand, arm, and he's just sending him flying. You get your filthy old Majin Buu reject on somewhere. You can't be talking about people when you're right. Pulling his fist back. Reject! Punching the boar right in the face. Don't mess with the real Saiyans. Hybrid Saiyans don't fight like us. Sending the boar flying into a mountain. Or two. Vegeta looks. Something like Super Saiyan 4. Never beaten by a 3. Whatever. I'm gone. Walking away. No, mostly everything goes the same. Chi-Chi dies and stuff. Oh, wait, yeah. That doesn't come until later. But, like, everything goes the same until the fight with Goku. Vegeta. Vegeta still doesn't get to take over because, and he aimed for the entire Goku family, including Gine. By the time Goku, Vegeta gets to Gine's house, Goku instant transmissions to him, why is Vegeta in his Super Saiyan 4 form? I didn't even know he had Super Saiyan 4. Vegeta. No. Since he didn't know this, he was like, "Jeez Louise." So then he was like, "What is he doing?" Hey, Vegeta, you know you can like, "Shut up, Kakarot! Get out of my way!" Punching Goku in the stomach, sending him flying. Vegeta, that wasn't very nice. "Kakarot, don't worry. After your mother, I'll kill you." What? Vegeta, what are you saying? "Don't worry, Kakarot. It's gonna be over very soon." Vegeta! He transforms into Super Saiyan 4, punching the fool right in the face. "You're not killing my mom. Got that?"
"Kakarot, just die."
Now, Vegeta's Majin, and he's fighting Goku! Goku! And it's practically like, in canon, "Get your big tail on from yourself!" Sorry, I'm just... So... It's Goku. Goku trying not to go full power on him. Like, he's... No, like, I'm not saying, like, he has SSJ God or anything. I'm just saying, like, he's not trying to go full power. He doesn't want... He's kind of debating if you could... should kill him or not. But then Gine and Chi-Chi run out of the house. "Goku, why are you training in front of our house? Chi-Chi! Gine, get out of here!" "What? Goku, what's the meaning of this?" "He's trying to kill you." "No, I'm not. Your son just started a... Your son and your husband started attacking me out of nowhere. I'll defend you. Get out of here!" Tears start coming down Goku's face. "Please, I don't want neither one of you to die." He's lying. Wanna know how I know he's lying? Look at the look on his face. He's smiling. Vegeta didn't really know like anything. He's just saying that. "Goku, why would you do this? You thought we would agree with you?" "What? Who do I believe? Come on, Gine! Flying Nimbus!" The Flying Nimbus comes down for Chi-Chi and Gine, because I know they're probably pure-hearted. Flying Nimbus, and it flies towards Goku. Flying Nimbus, take Gine and Chi-Chi somewhere safe where Vegeta can't find them. And then the Flying Nimbus takes off. "Well, I guess we can destroy this place up then," No, this is my house. This is where me, Gohan, Chi-Chi, Goten, and Gohan live. You're not breaking this place. You're not even gonna lay your hand on it. Vegeta looks at Gine. Goku, look, there's a bird. There's a dead bird. Goku looks, no! And then Vegeta flies away, full speed ahead. Vegeta, don't fly with me! And then Goku powers up. Kaioken! Using Kaioken in Super Saiyan 4 form. Vegeta! Landing right in front of Vegeta. And then he takes his foot. Vegeta! Kicking Vegeta in the face, sending him flying into a mountain pretty far away. Goku flies towards Vegeta. Are you done yet? Kakarot, you're pretty weak for being over me. Having more forms than me makes you stronger? No. Having more will than me? I don't think that's it. Having more pride? We all know I have more of that. It's just that you saved the world more. Wanna know something, Goku? Or Kakarot? I'm done with people saying you're stronger than me. I'm way stronger than you. When the androids came, guess what? I was way stronger than you. You couldn't even move. Goku's just standing there, taking it because he knows if he mentions anything, he'll get that. Remember when I first came? I was stronger than you. Remember when Raditz came? I was stronger than you. And I know I was stronger than you when we were kids. I am the mighty Vegeta, the Prince of all Saiyans. Just because you're the Prince of all Saiyans doesn't mean you have to be a brat. Kakarot, you are going to pay! Vegeta powers up. Don't play with me! Charging at Goku. Vegeta, you're the only one playing! Kamehameha! Huh? And then he stops. Final! And he's like, kind of, you know, like when you slide and they're just charging up a move? That's what he does, doing. Final! Kamehameha! Ha! Flash! And there's a beam struggle. Vegeta, remember this? Kaioken times 3! What? He's using Kaioken on top of it. Brings me back to old memories that I'm about to destroy. Don't you play with me, Kakarot! Powering up. Find it and take it to this level! Kaioken times 4! The struggle stops. Vegeta's final flash gets towards Goku, taking Goku out. Vegeta sees Goku saying, Vegeta, help me. Goku falls on the ground. Vegeta, I will stop you. Before that Majin Buu gets to my family, I need to go stop him. Then I'm gonna kill them. Killing them will be a piece of cake from Saiyan elite like me. With Vegeta flying off, looking at Goku's body, then flying away. See, I've overpowered Kakarot. Even with this pathetic Kaioken transformation, he couldn't even beat me.
Hinata saw this entire fight.
Goku
starts wiping tears away. She powers up, going Super Saiyan for a little while until fainting. Vegeta flies away. Goku, with the last of his power, puts his two fingers on his hand. Bardock, dead. Teleporting to dead. Vegeta looks back. What happened to Kakarot's body? It's probably just because he died. Bardock is just standing there, keeping lookout. Goku is right in front of him. Right when Goku gets there, Bardock asks Goku, "Son, what's wrong? What happened to you?" "Vegeta happened. He was controlled by Babidi, and he attempted to kill Kine. Me. And he's after Majin Buu now, but he's going to try to kill you and Gohan." "How did you lose to him?" "Dad, you've always been stronger than him." "No, I haven't always been stronger than him." Vegeta made some fair points that I had to agree with. "How am I supposed to be Almighty Goku if I can't be my own prince?" Bardock squats down and slaps Goku. "Son, if you talk like that one more time, I promise to God, bro, I will put you down on my own." "Dad, you think it's all about beating the person that's the prince of your race or the person that rules over you? You beat Frieza, one of the strongest people in this universe. And your son, Gohan, beat Cell. And you're stronger than that Gohan back then, now. And look at it. Look, you're going to beat Majin Buu, alright? You've beaten Vegeta before. You don't have to beat him now." "Dad, I didn't really beat him. It doesn't matter. You, your team, whatever you want to say, you still beat him." "But shut up!" And he slaps Goku again. "Are you ready to go to the underworld?" "Sorry, Dad." Fainting on the ground. "Gohan, go get him one of those sensu bean things. We're gonna go somewhere to train. The Supreme Kai asked me if I wanted to go. And bring your little girlfriend along. I think he won't mind." She's not my..." "Yes, sir." Flying towards Kame's house. Now, he picks up his mom and his grandmom because, he knows Vegeta is after him, and he sees them on the way home, so he picks them, and they take a ride on the flying Nimbus, full speed ahead, and they go to Supreme Kai's world, and that's the last of we see of them for a little while. Now, they do train. Now, Chi-Chi is just there to be a cook with Gine sometimes helping, but they train Gine because Gine, she's a Saiyan. She has lots of potential. If she can use that potential right, she can probably get a job done. At least that's what they're hoping. Now, they pick up Raditz on it during this training, so he can help
help. So I guess the entire thing would go the same, except the fight with Majin Buu and Goku. That wouldn't happen. But Goku still does get revived. Gohan breaks the Z-Sword and everything like that. Everything goes the same. So, yeah. Whatever. Yeah! Now Vegeta still does do that thing. His final explosion on Majin, Boo, 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 Boo. Sorry. He still does do his final explosion on Majin Buu. But Majin Buu's still there. And I guess everything would go up until Gohan arrives. Except Goku won't be there. And Chi-Chi won't die. Yes, Chi-Chi won't die. Thank God. Because when she died, I was like, the perfect wife. Because if you don't know, ever since I found out how good Chi-Chi could cook, like, I'm like. But, yeah, besides the point. Now, the team shows up in Noogies and their base form. Why are they in their base form? Whatever. But their powers increased massively. They might even be able to beat him. Beep Boo. Now the team is pretty really cocky. Really. Really. Cocky. And Vegeta's just in the background like, whatever. They've got a power boost. But their power. Everyone except Gohan. Their power levels aren't even close to what Goku's was in SSJ4. Why doesn't Goku just finish him off quickly? Whatever, it's probably just because he wants to have fun. That's that ratchet old saying. His family could die and he wants to have fun. Now, the Go family is fighting. Gohan telling him that he's about to die. The boy's stronger than him. And they get cocky, like how Gohan did. And Gohan and Bardock get absorbed. Now, with no one else there, Goku looks at Vegeta, jumping towards Vegeta. Vegeta, we're gonna make a truce for now. What? Kakarot, you must be joking. A truce between us? You must be joking. Vegeta, a truce. After this truce, you can try to get revenge on my family all you want. But just know, I won't let you do that. Fine, Kakarot. What's the truce? The truce is, we're gonna fuse. Here, put this earring on. What? I'm not gonna wear that earring. It's so we can fuse. Fine. As long as I don't stay together with you all the time. Oh, about that, Vegeta. Vegeta has the thing fully on by now. When we're finished? Oh, we'll stay fused. Wait, what? Kakarot? And they are fused. We are Vegito! That's a good name. Kakarot, just fight! Charging at him. Here we go, Vegeta! Here's an uppercut for you. Oh, you want us to be on top of you? Ha! Kakarot, stop playing with him! No, just hit it! Galak! Kamehameha! Fine then, if you won't die, we'll take it to the next level!
Yes, Kakarot. This is the Vegeta voice. Is just this is
Super Vegeta 4. We are Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. Can't even handle our attacks. Must be good to be gum. Sending Boo flying with one punch to the face.
Now, Kakarot. Now, we will use our strongest attack. Final. Ha! Times 20! Big Bang Attack!
In his last desperation, throwing it right at Vegeta Blue's. But the when it first goes, Vegeta SSJ4, Big Bang, Final Flash, Kamehameha, times 1,000, evaporates it. Say,
now, get it!
Boo opens his mouth.
I'll just kill your friends then. No, you won't.
He moves it around Boo. And he keeps on doing that. He's using the guidance comment on my hub type of technique.
You're not killing your friends.
Stopping the attack thing.
Stupid.
Jumping into his mouth, sending him, so he's so much stronger now. What they do is, they don't defuse yet. What they do is they get all their friends out, they jump out, and then they tell everyone,
now use your strongest attack. Big Bang, final, Kamehameha, times 1,000.
Everyone uses their moves, and this takes out the Super Boo. And Boo is there. And that's the end of the Boo threat. Now, I know this is pretty long, so let me go ahead and hit that outro. I hope you guys like this video. Be sure to slap that like button. And I'll see you guys next time in the Resurrection X. Battle of Gods Saga. See you in peace. See you guys next time. Big Bang. Peace.